there's 100 billion stars in the galaxy, so I can't believe that this is the only star where life started. I didn't realize how big was the discovery. I thought it was a good discovery, and we did a good job, but actually we completely changed the astrophysics. 1995 was an extraordinary time when we announced the discovery of the first planet orbiting under the star. But the real surprise was the planet we found. Nobody, including us, is the kind of planet we had in mind. That planet is named according to the star the planet is orbiting, which is the star 51 Pegasi, in the Pegasi constellation. And because it's a planet we don't see, we had a little bit of a B, so we detected 51 Peg B. I frankly didn't expect that we would get the Nobel Prize. It's an extraordinary opportunity because it gave me a bit more freedom to do maybe a bit different kind of work than I was doing before, which I hope will have an impact on, not for me, but the future generation of scientists. After 30 years, I never have enough. So every scientist has always this bit of frustration. We always want to do more. The related question when you have a planet is, well, what about life? And it's clear that it's a very, very big question. It's unlikely I will have a direct answer. I will see the answer, but I think that I can help developing this field. And this is the reason why I came to ETH, actually, to help working with my colleagues here, establishing the center, the COPL center. And as a scientist, we have to make sure that we inspire also the future generation, because as a scientist, we only exist because we had other scientists before, and science will only exist because we're preparing the next generation of science. So we have this role to pass over the message in a way, and also to communicate what we're doing as broadly as we can. I really hope that we're going to find life beyond Earth. It's one of these big questions, and I'm pretty sure this question will be answered. It's just a matter of time.